I wrote with my friend Jack Antonoff.
One of my best friends, Sarah Quinn, who's half Tegan and Sarah, for a long time was telling me about her friend Sarah Bareilles, and I was like, you have to meet her, she's the coolest.
He came so highly recommended. She's like, he's one of my best friends, you're gonna love him. You know, if nothing else, you just like have a great time.
And the first time we ever got in a room together, that's when we did Brave. Which, looking back on now, is really cool because I'm so proud of the way it came out.
And we sat and he played me some tracks he had been working on, and it just immediately, the track jumped out at me. I immediately started writing words, the rhythm came really quickly, the chorus came really quickly. It was just, well, there was a lot of great synergy there.
I felt extremely inspired by her, extremely honored to be there, extremely excited that my ideas were going to be taken into a place that was so much bigger and grander than they could have been because she was there.
What I love about Jack is that he... It felt really safe to want to say something more with him as like a co-pilot there.
And I think Brave might be the first thing that I've ever been even remotely involved in that I have no like conflicting feelings about. I don't know why. Maybe that's because of how pure the process was. Maybe that's because of the lyrical content I believe so deeply in.
Lyrics of Brave were inspired by partially by a really close friend of mine who was really struggling with coming out.
Brave is obviously a broad song that's gonna mean a lot to a lot of people, but to me, I'll always sort of internalize it just as a real civil rights anthem in a time when there are no civil rights anthems and there's a giant need for a civil rights anthem.
I think there's so much honor and integrity and beauty in being able to be who you are. And it's important to be brave because by doing that you also give others permission to do the same.